هيا على الفلاح.
Subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions of the causes that we're in pain and suffering is we are not thankful. مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ إِن شَكَرْتُمْ. When we are in pain, when we are suffering, what happens? We appreciate the blessing. How weak we are, brothers and sisters, that we don't appreciate a blessing until it is taken away from us. We don't appreciate how fortunate we are until that fortune is taken away from us. We don't appreciate our health until we fall sick. We don't appreciate our time until we get busy. We don't appreciate our wealth until our wealth becomes constricted on us. And so of the wisdoms of a little bit of pain, a little bit of suffering, it jolts us. It makes us awake. It makes us understand that this is a blessing that Allah has given us. And we need to thank Allah for those blessings. In Surah An-Nisa, verse 147, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ إِن شَكَرْتُمْ وَآمَنْتُمْ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ شَاكِرًا عَلِيمًا. What will Allah gain by punishing you? مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ. It's a rhetorical question. Why do you think Allah will punish you? What's the purpose of Allah punishing you? If you are thankful and you believe in Him. Now this beautiful verse, it lays for us the foundation of why this world is a world of pain and suffering. And the wisdom is outlined in this verse. What will Allah gain by punishing you if you are thankful and you believe in Him? So this ayah tells us that there are reasons why we are in suffering and pain. Of the wisdoms as well is to remove arrogance. We are so weak, brothers and sisters. Just because we have a little bit, our hearts become so big as if we are, astaghfirullah, semi-divine. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will show us we are mortals. We are the abd and there is a rabb above us. And everyone amongst us has to come to that point in our lives where we have to humble ourselves in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even Iblis, even Shaytan, he had to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said, oh Allah, allow me to live until judgment day. In that humility is our saving. Of course, Iblis only asked that one thing and that's it. He turned away. But in humbling ourselves to Allah is our salvation. Of the wisdoms as well, is that in that humbling, we discover the importance and the necessity of dua, of prayer. Allah says in the Quran, فَلَوْلَا إِذْ جَاءَهُمْ بَأْسُنَا تَضَرَّعُوا. Why didn't they call out to us when they tasted our punishment? وَلَكِنْ قَسَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ. But their hearts became hard. So Allah is wanting you to make dua at times of calamity. Of the wisdoms of calamity is you raise your hands up to Allah. You rediscover the sweetness of believing in Allah, of making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not a problem to make dua at times of calamity. The problem is after the calamity is over, you forget Allah. That's a problem. But Allah never criticizes making dua when you're in suffering or in pain. In fact, this is a part of human nature. Allah says in the Quran that mankind, when any calamity befalls him, he makes dua, قَائِمًا أَوْ قَاعِدًا. Whether he's standing or sitting or lying down, he's going to make dua. Allah doesn't criticize that. Allah then criticizes, once I remove the calamity, then he forgets about me. That is the problem. But to think of Allah at times of stress, this is the essence of iman. And it is the goal and one of the main goals. Sometimes life becomes so sweet, we forget about Allah. So a calamity takes place, a musibah, an affliction, and we are forced to rediscover Allah. That rediscovering Allah is the wisdom of the calamity. Ibn al-Qayyim says, any disaster that causes you to come closer to Allah is not a disaster, it is a blessing. Because anything that brings you closer to Allah is worth any cost. Nothing is more precious than a relationship with Allah. And wallahi, brothers and sisters, I ask every one of you to think about when you were the closest to Allah. And I guarantee it will be at a time of great stress in your life, at a time of great calamity, when the situation was very tough. You had to have a strong relationship with Allah. That relationship is the purpose of the calamity. Allah does not take pleasure in punishing. مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ. Allah Azza wa Jalla Allah is a merciful God. But just like a parent at times has to inflict a pain on the child for a greater good, we take our children to the doctor for shots. We discipline our children, but we love our children for their greater good. وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى. To Allah belongs the better example than this one. Just like a loving parent at times has to inflict a little bit of pain for a greater good, infinitely more, Allah's wisdom dictates that there is small amounts of suffering for a much greater good. Of the wisdoms as well for that pain and suffering is that we have to earn our place in Jannah. And by earn, I don't mean a tit for tat, because our deeds will never earn Jannah. Rather, what I mean is we need to demonstrate to Allah with whatever meager results that we do that we are worthy of Allah's mercy to enter Jannah. Our deeds will never earn Jannah in and of themselves. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there is no one amongst you who will enter Jannah just because of his deeds. They said, not even you, O Messenger of Allah. He said, not even me, unless Allah envelopes me in His rahmah. So we don't earn Jannah. However, what we do is we earn Allah's rahmah, and then Allah's rahmah will give us Jannah. And we earn Allah's rahmah by demonstrating whatever meager good that we can do. And that's why Allah says, وَكَانَ اللَّهُ شَاكِرٌ. Allah is Shakir. Of the names of Allah is Shakir. Shakir means you do a little bit and Allah will give you much more than what you have earned. Because if Allah gave you what you have earned, you would get nothing of Jannah. You do a little bit and Allah is Shakir. So of the wisdom of the pain and suffering is that we combat that pain, we combat that evil with good. There could be no good unless there was evil. We need evil, and to combat it, we need to demonstrate our good. Simple question: how will you be charitable? How will you give food to the hungry when there are no hungry people? How will you sponsor the orphan when there are no orphans to sponsor? How will you feed the needy when there are no needy? So there, the wisdom of evil is not the evil. It is to bring the good. It is to show the goodness. And in that goodness is our salvation. The final point that we'll mention is that of the wisdoms of this pain and suffering is to alleviate the real pain of the akhirah. This pain of this world is bearable. The pain of this world is bearable. The pain of the hereafter is not bearable. And the righteous, the good Muslim, will embrace this pain. He won't want it, but once it happens, he will thank Allah that, okay, this is going to be a means of kafara, a means of forgiveness, so that I don't have to face the real pain of the akhirah. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, do not curse the fever. Do not curse when you're in fever. Don't curse it, for that is going to eliminate the fire of Jahannam. The fever for the believer will eliminate the fire of Jahannam. So in these pains and sufferings, Allah Azza wa Jal is testing us, testing our faith, testing our patience, testing our iman. And in those tests, we shall rise up ranks. The end result, brothers and sisters, simply put, there is no pure evil for the believer. There is no negative for the believer. Any negative, any pain, any suffering can be converted by the believer to be infinitely more good. It is in your attitude and your response. It is in how you react to that negative. If you react with that positive, if you have a positive attitude, you are patient, you put your trust in Allah, then there's never going to be negative and evil. You will get much more out of that negative. So much so, our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that there will be people on Judgment Day, they have suffered so much, when they see the rewards of their suffering on Judgment Day, they will wish they would have suffered more in this world to get that reward in the akhirah. So do not take a negative as something that is evil for you. لا تحسبوه شرا لكم بل هو خير لكم. Don't take a negative as something bad. It will be for your betterment. Yes, you make dua to lift the evil. We don't like pain. But when it happens, we have to stand up like Muslims. We have to put our trust in Allah, have sabr in Allah, have yaqeen in Allah. And yes, we make dua to Allah to alleviate, but we always have a positive attitude with Allah. We have the firm faith that this is simply a stumbling block to test me, and inshaAllah ta'ala, I will rise up to the test, I'll answer the challenge, and at the end, I shall be a better person, a higher believer. My reward in Jannah will go up because of the response to this test. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those who are able to pass each and every test with the highest of colors.